सो लेट स्टार्ट विथ जोमेटोज आईपीओ। जोमेटो आईपीओ आ रहा है, आप सबने सुना ही होगा। इट्स गोइंग टू यू नो रेज अ लॉट ऑफ मनी, लाइक वन ऑफ द लार्जेस्ट आईपीओ। सो उसके पहले लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट बिजनेस इट इज इनटू। एंड आप सबने यूज किया ही होगा, मोस्टली चांसेस आर प्रीटी हाई दोज हु आर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो। आपने जोमेटो की एप्लीकेशन कहीं ना कहीं एक ना एक बार यूज की होगी या किसी के मोबाइल में देखी होगी। सो जोमेटो क्या करता है, बिजनेस क्या है जोमेटो का? सिंपल है, जोमेटो इज लाइक एन एग्रीगेटर, जैसे आपका उबर हो गया, ठीक है, या फिर ओला हो गया। जोमेटो इज सिमिलरली एग्रीगेटर, बट इट्स लाइक अ फूड डिलीवरी प्लेटफॉर्म। तो जोमेटो एग्रीगेट करता है सारे रेस्टोरेंट को अपने प्लेटफॉर्म पे, उनको लिस्ट करता है अपने प्लेटफॉर्म पे। पीपल कैन गो ऑन दर एप्लीकेशन, लुक फॉर दी रेस्टोरेंट्स एंड लुक फॉर द फूड्स, एंड कस्टमर कैन डायरेक्टली ऑर्डर द फूड। जोमेटो जो ऑर्डर रहता है वो अपने जो भी एप्लीकेशन से नोटिफिकेशन भेजता है रेस्टोरेंट को, रेस्टोरेंट देन सेंड्स द फूड यूजिंग द जोमेटो डिलीवरी फ्लीट। सो दिस इज बेसिकली द जोमेटो मॉडल ऑफ बिजनेस। एंड यहाँ पे डिलीवरी के चार्जेस के लिए जोमेटो कुछ परसेंटेज आपको चार्ज करता है। यूजुअली इट वॉज 30-40 रुपीज एंड इट कीप्स ऑन वराइंग। सो दिस इज बेसिक यू कैन से बिजनेस मॉडल ऑफ जोमेटो एंड हाउ इट अर्न्स मनी। Let's discuss about the future things and how the money is going to be raised. What is the IPO part? So, Zomato is coming up with nearly 8,000 rupees public ke paas se raise karne wale hun log, aur 7,500 rupees usme se they are going to use for their own organic as well as inorganic growth. 8,000 crore mein se something 375 crore ke aaspaas info edge lega. Pehle 750 unhone decide kiya tha, now it has been 375 crores roughly. And InfoEdge आपने सुना होगा, Naukri.com, that is the InfoEdge company. तो उनका कुछ स्टेक है ये कंपनी में, सो वो ये स्टेक सेल करेगी और 375 crores अपने पास लेके जाएंगे। रिमेनिंग अमाउंट Zomato विल यूज फॉर कस्टमर एक्विजिशन, एडवर्टीजमेंट करेंगे, अच्छे अच्छे ऑफर्स देंगे ये जो पैसा रेस कर रहे हैं उससे, एंड उनका जो डिलीवरी एज वेल एज द टेक्नोलॉजी इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर जो है वहाँ पे उन लोग इम्प्रूवमेंट लाएंगे। एंड ऐसे भी बात चलती है कि जो डिलीवरी इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर में दे आर प्लानिंग टू मूव टूवर्ड्स fully EV, so कुछ पैसा वहां पे भी यूज होगा। सो ऑर्गेनिक एज वेल एज इनऑर्गेनिकली दे यूज दिस मनी टू एक्सपांड देयर बिजनेस। Zomato इज इंडियाज फर्स्ट प्रोफेशनली मैनेज टेक आईपीओ। सो अब तक का फर्स्ट कंपनी है जिसका मैनेजमेंट जो है वो प्रोफेशनल है एंड दे आर मूविंग अप विद एन आईपीओ। यूजुअली इंडियंस वी आर वेरी कंजर्वेटिव व्हेन वी लुक एट द प्रमोटर्स होल्डिंग, सो दिस कंसेप्ट इज नॉट वेरी मच फेमस नाउ in India particularly, but this concept is very much famous in USA or the other Western countries like European countries, where companies are mostly professionally managed and the investors are also liberal over there and they accept the companies where professionals are managing the company. Zomato is not sort of, you know, typical Indian company where promoters hold maximum stake. So promoter here holds very less stake, something around 10-15% ke aaspaas, and majority of the stake is held by the P or the venture capitals. You can see the names like Alipay, InfoEdge, which is the Naukri.com. Uber ke saath mein inka no collaboration ho gaya, to Uber ka bhi abhi stake hai, Uber Eats ka, and the investors are there on the board, you can say. So this is like India's first professionally managed tech company, which is coming up with IPO, and it is 7th largest unicorn in India. So unicorn wo hota hai ki jiska valuation $1 billion ho. इन रूपी टर्म्स जिसका वैल्यूएशन 7,500 करोड़ के आसपास हो। सो Zomato का वैल्यूएशन नियरली 25,000 करोड़ के आसपास है एंड इट इज 7th लार्जेस्ट स्टार्टअप कंपनी, यू कैन से, इन टर्म्स ऑफ यूनिकॉर्न। सो दिस वर सम की फैक्ट्स अबाउट Zomato एंड द मैनेजमेंट। लेट्स लुक एट द अदर फैक्ट शीट। सो Zomato हैव प्रोसेस 24,000 ऑर्डर्स, उनके पास प्रो सब्सक्राइबर्स जो है, यू कैन से प्रो मेंबर्स, वो 15 लाख से which you know recurring इनको पेमेंट जाता है इनकी तरफ से, समथिंग प्रो सब्सक्राइबर की फीस जो है इट इज 150 रुपीज फॉर 3 मंथ्स इफ आई एम नॉट रॉन्ग, एंड द मंथली एक्टिव यूजर्स इज रियली ग्रेट, लाइक 3 करोड़ मंथली यूजर्स है जो Zomato यूज करते हैं एवरी मंथ, विच इज रियली हाई, एंड समथिंग 1,70,000 डिलीवरी पार्टनर्स आर कनेक्टेड विद Zomato, कीप ऑन डिलीवरिंग यूजली ऑन डेली बेसिस, एंड नियरली 4 लाख रेस्टोरेंट्स हैव टाई अप विद Zomato एंड पीपल कैन यू नो लाइक across India 4 lakh restaurants are there on the Zomato's platform. So really a wide variety of food you can select from the mobile application, and they have like no concentration is there for Zomato, like एक प्लेटफॉर्म अगर एक रेस्टोरेंट छोड़ जाता है जोमेटो को, तो उनको उतना इम्पैक्ट नहीं पड़ेगा, बिकॉज नियरली 4 लाख रेस्टोरेंट जो है दे आर कनेक्टेड विद जोमेटो. सो थोड़ा सा डाइवर्सिफिकेशन आप कह सकते हो, यूथ डाइवर्सिफिकेशन इन टर्म्स ऑफ द पार्टनर्स वाइज. लेट्स लुक एट द वैल्यूएशन पार्ट. सो माई टीम हैज टेकन दिस थिंग फ्रॉम मिंट एंड दिस इज द जर्नी ऑफ जोमेटो. सो 2008-09 के आसपास कंपनी फॉर्म हुआ था एंड देन 2010 में इन्फोएज विच इज नौकरी उन्होंने इन्वेस्ट किया जोमेटो में. फिर सीकोया आया विच इज नो वेल नोन वी सी नोन अक्रॉस द वर्ल्ड, उन्होंने इन्वेस्ट किया. फिर चाइना का एंट ग्रुप एंड टाइगर ग्लोबल इन्होंने भी इन्वेस्ट किया. सो ऑल ऑफ द मार्की नेम्स आर देयर ऑन द जोमेटोस, यू नो जोमेटोस बोर्ड और यू कैन से जोमेटोस शेयर होल्डर्स. सो समथिंग रियली ग्रेट ओवर हियर विच लाइक बहुत अच्छे अच्छे इन्वेस्टर्स है जिन्होंने जोमेटो में इन्वेस्ट किया एंड नाउ दे आर गोइंग टू गेट रिवॉर्डेड फॉर दिस. सो एज फार एज आई नो आई थिंक यू नो इन्फोएज जिन्होंने इन्वेस्ट किया था वे बैक, सो दे इन्वेस्टेड समथिंग एट ऑन एवरेज लेस देन 2 रुपीज पर बाइंग उनकी है. नाउ द कंपनी इज लिस्टिंग एट 76, सो यू कैन जस्ट इमेजिन हाउ मच मनी दे हैव मेड बाय अर्ली स्टेज इन्वेस्टिंग इन टू जोमेटो एंड दिस इज हाउ द स्टार्टअप्स रिवॉर्ड यू. सो huge money is going to be made by the VCs and you can say the PEs who have invested in the early stage of Zomato. ये हो गया अपना micro part. Let's look at the macro part, which is very much I am very much interested into. So the micro is really great for India and how it is going to impact the Zomato and the other startups. So let's look at macros in India. So if you can see on your screen, India is going to be the largest or you can say the fastest country across this, you know, 5 countries in terms of growth of GDP. So India is going to be the fastest GDP grower in something next 5 years. And just look at the CAGR where India is growing. So in past 5 years, you can say India grew at something 8.4% CAGR GDP jo tha wo. And by 2025, it is expected ki Indian economy jo hai, Modi sahab ka jo sapna hai ki $5 trillion tak Indian economy pahunchegi. So something at 7% CAGR ke aaspaas hai, Indian economy will grow. And if the economy grows, if the GDP grows, definitely apna per capita income grow hoga. And per capita income grow hoga, to logo ke paas mein paise zyada hoge, disposable income jo bolte, discretionary spending zyada hogi. Log, you can say log spend acche se karege jab unke paas disposable income zyada hoga. So there is direct correlation between growth of GDP and you know like spending by people, and if people have decent money with them to spend like disposable income, so they will definitely spend, you know, ordering food, going to malls and going to restaurants, ordering from restaurants and entertainment and so on and so forth. So Indians are going to be the spenders. This is going to be the key thing in next 4 to 5 years. The great another thing for micro is India ka jo internet penetration hai, it's very low. So something out of 140 crores population of India, only 33% have smartphone penetration. And by 2025, it is expected to double from here. So abhi jo bhi user base hai India ka, you know, like something around 60 crore log ke aaspaas smartphone ka penetration hai, not even 60 crores. I'm saying really high number, but yeah, even lesser than that. So something around 40-50 crores people are using the smartphone, and this number is going to increase, you know, like it's going to double. So something 80 crores ke aaspaas people would be having smartphone access, you know, by something around, not 80 crore, but yeah, something 70 crore it's going to be the number by 2025. So this number is going to double from here, and smartphone penetration increase hoga, so definitely Zomato ko kahin na kahin pe se benefit hoga. Because people will use smartphone, they'll use the Zomato app and they'll download the app and then order. So direct correlation with India's under penetration as well as, you know, the direct increasing penetration which we'll see in next 5 years. So Zomato might get directly benefited because of this internet penetration as well as the smartphone penetration. Now let's do a comparative analysis with India, US and China. So these are, you can say, like 3 major players in startups across the world. So India ki population something around 140 crore ke aaspaas hai, and China too is something around 145 crores ke aaspaas. So yeah, we are going to beat China in upcoming years. Let's hope we don't do that, but that is the fact which, you know, most of the economists and as well as analysts say ki next 10 years, if we grow at the same rate and the China's population control is also at the same rate, we are going to beat the Chinese in terms of highest population country. So access to internet is very less as of now compared to both US and China, where US mostly 90% people have access to internet, and China nearly 63% of the people have access to internet. The great part is at the bottom of the screen. अभी जो इंडिया का फूड डिलीवरी यूजर्स बेस है, इट्स वेरी 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 लेस, नो लाइक लेस देन 10% ऑफ पॉपुलेशन इज हैविंग फूड डिलीवरी का यूजर बेस, यू कैन से. सो नियरली 13 क्रोर्स के आसपास, रफली 13 टू 14 क्रोर्स, लेट्स से इवन 15 क्रोर्स नाउ. कंपेयर टू यूएस, इट इज, यू नो, यूएसए नियरली 4 टाइम्स पीपल ऑर्डर इन टर्म्स ऑफ परसेंटेज टू इंडियंस एज वेल एज चाइना की बात करो तो रफली 50% ऑफ पॉपुलेशन इज the, you know, is our users of food delivery applications and the platform. So agar ye jo percent hai 9% se, let's say it goes to even 30%, so that is going to be a huge number. Okay, and talking about the food delivery market in India, as of now it is like mainly it's three players market, you can say Zomato, Swiggy, and to certain extent Foodpanda and the other players. So these are the leading three players, you can say. And Foodpanda ka I saw an analysis like the growth is, it's like actually degrowing, if I'm not wrong. So that is the thing. But Zomato and Swiggy are the core rivals, you can see, in the Indian food delivery space. And jabhi bhi ye number badhega 9% se, let's say 20%, 30%, 50% over a period of next 10, 20, 30 years, Zomato as well as Swiggy are going to be the direct beneficiary. Amazon delivery bhi aa chuki hai, but it has not been a huge competitor. But who knows, in next 5-10 years, let's say Jeff Bezos says ki we want to go fully into Indian market, so we might see an increased competition in Indian delivery space. So that was the macro analysis of India and how a rising GDP, a rising, you can say, the internet penetration as well as mobile penetration is going to impact as well as benefit the food delivery platforms in India. So we are at a very initial stage, both Zomato as well as Swiggy. Let's see how it pans out. If the things grow from this particular 9% to 40%, मैंने आपको बता दिया how these players are going to benefit it. Here is a pair comparison between Zomato and Swiggy, the, you know, two main rivals, you can say. So Swiggy charges something 20 to 25% as commission. Zomato 23% charge karta as commission for, you know, from the restaurants. And average order value AOV for Zomato is bit higher compared to Swiggy. So Zomato has something 400 ke aaspaas ka average order value as well as compared to Swiggy, which is 380 to 400. Restaurant partners with Zomato are higher compared to Swiggy, as well as Zomato is having more presence in the cities compared to Zomato is having more presence compared to the Swiggy in terms of presence into cities. And Swiggy has more delivery partners compared to Zomato, like 2 lakh se zyada abhi delivery partners hai compared to Zomato part. So this was a comparative analysis to give you a brief idea how the competition is working, the direct competition, which is Swiggy. And Swiggy's valuation is also a bit higher, I think $3.7 billion compared to Zomato. So let's see how it comes up with, either it is raising money from the direct market or the primary or second. Let's see how it's raising money. VC se raise karta hai, phir IPO se. So that was about Zomato's part, and these are the key things you have to watch out for. So Zomato is like a high growth business. So definitely, if you are a person who thinks ki, you know, jo bhi maine abhi bataya, investment, international macro point as well as micro point se, if you think this thesis of high internet penetration, smartphone penetration, growing GDP is going to work, so this thesis will work that it is high growth business. And simultaneously, yeah, it is not profitable yet. So if you are a hardcore value investor, if you think ki nahi, abhi company profitable nahi hai, so it is advisable that you stay away. But again, take your financial advice. I'm nobody to advise you. But this is the basic thing. Like Zomato is growing really fast over a period of 5 years. But yeah, it is yet to turn into profitability. As far as my readings go, it is expected to turn, you know, it is expected for Zomato to be profitable by something 2023, 2024. So it is into growing business. It is just, you know, expanding its market. The company expand karta apna market. So usually company bahut paisa kharch karta in advertisement and the organic growth and expanding its fleets and the other thing. So isi ke chalte company ko cost zyada aa jati hai initial years mein, and that's the reason companies usually, startups are usually not in profit in earliest, but once they are established, they, you know, start making money. The same was case with Amazon. After the AWS started, the Amazon profitability increased. So initial years, Amazon also was not making that much profit. And now, you know, Amazon is like one of the largest companies in the world. Zomato is typically a futuristic business. So agar aap conservative valuation value karte ho, so if you are a conservative investor, you might not like the current valuation. And I have not particularly discussed about the valuations part, because kuch hai nahi value karne ke liye, earnings nahi hai. So it's a bit difficult to do the valuation part. So it's some sort of available at overvaluation, you can say, but yeah, it's futuristic business and you have expectation ki Zomato future mein business mein paisa kamayega, profit make karega. So it's better that you can, you know, look into the IPO part. Other thing is that ab tak India mein jo bhi largest IPO aaye hain, as far as my understanding goes, Zomato is largest IPO in Indian history in last 13 years. So pichle 13 saal mein itna bada IPO nahi hai. So this is, I think, what Zomato is the first, you know, like the largest company in terms of IPO in last 13 years. And this is what I have observed, ki all the large IPOs have not actually been rewarding to equity shareholders. So you can take example like Reliance Power, Coal India, ONGC, and the sorts of like recently SBI cards. So listing gains utna zyada nahi hua in this large IPO. So if you are a person who wants listing gains, so I don't think Zomato is the case, but who knows, it may even open 30% up, or it may not even give premium listing. So that completely goes to listing part. But usually these sorts of large IPO, they usually don't have high listing gains. So 50%, 100% listing gains yahan pe nahi milta hai. And Reliance Power mein to main kya hi batau, aapko pata hi hoga ki jo IPO ka price ab tak nahi aaya hua hai. So that was again a curse of large IPO. So be mindful of that. And last but not the least, maine pehle hi bataya, it is professionally managed company. So, you know, like maine pehle bataya ki it's having low promoter holding company. So if you are a person who doesn't likes low promoter holding company, so you should be cautious of talking about, you know, whether you should apply for this IPO or not. So again, a disclaimer, it is best to take a financial advisor's advice. I'm not giving advice, I'm talking my point of view, what I'm going to do. So this is definitely a risky IPO, talking from today's point of view. But if I look at the future prospects and everything, and if my thesis plays out, jo bhi maine explain kiya hua hai, the, you know, rising GDP and the other parts of internet penetration and the other part, I think Zomato would be one of the key players in terms of market capitalization. And it is listing at 60,000 crores ke market capitalization ke aaspaas hai. So if everything goes well and thesis plays out, it is definitely worth taking risk. And I too am going to take some risk in this thing. Usually I don't invest into loss making company, but I am taking an exception. Let's see how it pays off to me. So I'm going to apply for a few lots of Zomato IPO. I'm going to take some risk. Okay. Zyada se zyada loss, it is like a conservative thing from my point of view, calculated risk. Zyada se zyada loss kitna hoga, like, you know, 20-30%. I'm okay with that. So I'm okay with taking some part of risk. You need to decide what is your risk profile. If you are high risk investor, you can definitely invest into IPO. If you are very conservative, aapko risk bear nahi hota hai. So it's better that you stay away from the IPO. But one more thing, like, most of the market investors across the world, they are very much interested into, you know, investing into Zomato. So be mindful of that. I'm not saying if they're investing into Zomato, you too should invest. But yeah, if they are, you know, pouring in huge sums of money, kuch na kuch unhone analysis kiya hoga. So think on that part too. And I think with that, maine bahut detail mein explain kar diya what is the analysis, what is the future prospect, as well as the thesis. So final decision is yours, whether you need to invest into IPO or not. Talking about me, I'm going to invest some part of, you know, some capital into this particular IPO and wait for long-term gains. I'm not here for listing gains. I'll, you know, keep on reviewing it every quarter and see if my thesis is working or not, usually at every 3 to 4 months. So with that, we can close today's, you know, video. And just do let me know your thoughts in the comment section, whether you are applying for the IPO or you are staying away. And do share this with your friends. Thanks a lot for watching the video. Goodbye.